स्टूडेंट, नाउ यू गोइंग टू सॉल्व दैट एक्सरसाइज 6.5 प्लस 10 जनरल मैथ्स क्वेश्चन नंबर 6। ए बी सी इज एन इक्विलेटरल ट्राइंगल ऑफ साइड 2A, फाइंड ईच ऑफ इट्स ऑल्टीट्यूड। स्टूडेंट, एज यू कैन सी इन द वीडियो, दिस इज द क्वेश्चन ऑफ यू नो इक्विलेटरल ट्राइंगल व्हिच साइड इज मेंशन हियर ट्वाइस ए। वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट द हाइट ऑफ द triangle. So let's have a look how to solve this one. Student, as you can see in the video, this is a diagram of the given triangle ABC. Remember that, student, this triangle is equilateral triangle, which means all sides are equal here, and sides are given here as, you know, twice A. So we can write down here twice A, the sides of the triangle. This side is also twice A. This side is also twice A, this side is also twice A, because in equilateral triangle all sides equal and all angles are also equal. Now one more thing, student, here the given portion which I have written from the main book, ABC is an equilateral triangle in which AB equal to BC equal to CA equal to twice A, which means all these three sides are equal to equal and the value is given twice A. And also look here, I have written that in the given portion that AD perpendicular BC and B perpendicular CA and CA perpendicular AB, but I have not drawn here. Now look, what is the reason that I have not drawn that BE perpendicular CA and CA perpendicular AB, why I have not drawn here? Now look, the reason is, since already I told you that it is an equilateral triangle. Now height of a triangle or height of a equilateral triangle from the vertex, if I draw a perpendicular to the opposite side of the base, this is the, you know, height of a triangle. And already I told you, from the vertex to the opposite side, if I draw the perpendicular, if it is perpendicular, then 90 degree, so AD is the height. And since it is an equilateral triangle, so it's you know, all heights will be equal, means BE will be here and CF will be here, so these two heights will be equal. If I find only AD, which is equivalent to BE and CF, that's why I have not drawn here the other two altitudes or height. So students, let's have a look how to solve this one. Student, now look how to solve this one. Here I am writing the solution, writing here the solution. Now look, student, after that, first of all, if I, you know, draw the height or perpendicular, which means, you know, these two sides are the two triangles, triangle ADB and triangle ADC. Now look, student, already I told you it is a perpendicular, which means 90 degree, so these two triangles we have to show that congruence. But how to show it? Look here. Now first of all, in triangle ADB and triangle ADC, student, here AB equal to AC, why? Because already mentioned in the given portion, AB equal to BC equal to CA. Moreover, it is an equilateral triangle. So we'll write down here that AB equal to AC, and we'll write down here, since triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle, first one. Now look, the second one, student, will be here that AD equal to AD common portion for the both the triangles. So we'll write down here AD equal to AD common side, or simply we can write common, and angle ADB, which means this side, angle ADB, which means this side 90 degree, and angle ADC 90 degree. So we'll write down here angle ADB equal to angle ADC, and each 90 degree. Now look, student, after that, so we can, you know, say here that you know, for this triangle, here is side and side, then this is angle, and this is also side, and you know, side in this angle. So we'll write down here that therefore triangle ADB congruence triangle ADC, and we'll write down here side angle criteria, criteria for the first one. Now look, student, after that, if it is do so, if these two triangles are congruent, so we can say that BD equal to DC, CPCT. We'll write down here BD equal to DC and this is CPCT. Student, look now, BD is equal to DC, which means D is the midpoint of, you know, BC. Moreover, AD is perpendicular on BC, which means D is the midpoint. So student, we can write down here that, you know, BD equal to half BC and CD equal to half BC. So here, student, what is the value of BC here? BC is twice A. So BD equal to half BC. Look here now. Now BD equal to half BC. Reason is that since D is the midpoint, D is the midpoint on BC. So what is the value of BC here? BC, value of BC is twice A. So we'll put down here twice A. Half into twice A. Cancel these two. So BD equal to A. Student, if BD equal to A, which means DC is also A. So I'm taking this one as our equation number 1. And we'll write down here that from 1, you know, BD equal to DC. BD is A, which means DC is also A. Now look, student, after that, we need to find the, you know, height of AD. Look here now in the diagram, we need to find out the height of AD. If we can find the height of AD, which means BE and CF also equal, because ABC is an equilateral triangle. So if we find only one height, this is equivalent to BE and CF. Now how to find out this height AD? Look here now, student. Now as you can see in the video, triangle ADB and triangle ADC both are right angle. Why? Because AD is perpendicular on BC and this angle is 90 degrees. So if I take an angle ADB, we can find out AD, and if I take angle ADC, we can find AD also. So any of the triangles if I take will be easier to finding the height AD. Now look, student, I am taking that angle ADB. Look here now, in triangle ADB, angle D equal to 90 degree, which means it is right angle. If it is right angle, student, so we can apply here the Pythagoras theorem. So what is the Pythagoras theorem? Hypo square equal to sum of the other two side square. Now what is hypo here in triangle ADB? Hypo is AB square equal to sum of the other two side, which means BD square plus AD square. Look into the diagram once. Look into the diagram once. Hypo square, triangle ADB. Hypo means AB. AB square equal to BD square plus AD square. Now look, student, after that, we'll just put down the value here directly. Value of AB, since BC equal to twice A, so AB is also twice A, CA is also twice A, because equilateral triangle all side equal. So here we'll write down here 2A whole square. The value of BD, BD is A only, so A square, and there is AD square. So we can apply here, since, you know, AB equal to BC equal to CA equal to 2IA, it is given part, given in the, you know, first portion of the geometry. So here now look, student, look here now, 2A square means 4A square, and there is A square plus AD square. Now student, look here, there is 4A square minus A square, taking A square on that side become minus, so AD square. Now last time will be here 3A square equal to AD square. Now look, if I remove the square from the both side, there is root 3A square equal to AD. Now square root cancels, so answer would be root 3A equal to AD. This is the, you know, height of the triangle. So if AD is, you know, root 3A, which means this is clearly indicate that, you know, BE and CF is also, you know, root 3A. So we write down here similarly AD equal to root 3A, which means BE equal to root 3A. लोखिए नाउ स्टूडेंट, बी इक्वल टू रूट थ्री ए एंड सी एफ इक्वल टू ऑल्सो रूट थ्री ए. सो दिस इज द आंसर ऑफ द क्वेश्चन. वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट द थ्री हाइट्स ऑफ ए ट्राइंगल. सो ऑलरेडी वी फाइंड आउट ऑल आंसर इज इक्वल रूट थ्री ए. वंस अगेन आई एम टेलिंग दैट स्टूडेंट डोंट कन्फ्यूज. हियर वी हैव फाइंड आउट बी एंड सी एफ ऑल्सो, बट आई हैव नॉट ड्रॉन हियर. वाई? बिकॉज सिंस इट इज एन इक्विलेटरल ट्राइंगल, इफ आई फाइंड आउट ओनली वन height of a triangle means AD, it is equivalent to BE and CF, that's why I have not drawn BE and CF. But answer is same, AD is root 3A, which means BE also root 3A and CF is also root 3A.